one thing we have to, several things we have to keep in our mind, and that is our continuous walk in faith.
Right.
We need to understand that this,
back.
What should humble every person is that our life has been granted.
Right.
It was given to you and me. Coming into the world, we were sent by the Creator. That keeps us, what is the word we use? We use often is the word humility. Keep us in humility when we understand that we are created.
Yeah.
We didn't create ourselves, but we have a Creator. And that Creator is called God in the Scriptures. We know that, excuse me,
yeah,
we have a revelation of the God whom no man has seen, and that revelation of God is in Jesus the Christ. Matter of fact, our theme for the whole year is remembering Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Very important. In our world, they don't want to even mention Jesus Christ. I was in school in college. I was in a psychology class, and they had what they call parapsychology. Bring in those of various religion, and they brought in a religion from the East. He's come from the out of the East, the Middle East, called Ekankar. You ever heard of Ekankar? The reason I said that is advertised on TV now. Ekankar. It's a wisdom of the ancient out of the East. And they bring that to this parapsychology. Introducing that convert religion, but mention Jesus in the class.
Ooh.
Excuse me, just a moment. Religion out of the East.
Out of the East. The Middle East. Yeah.
Middle East, right? Mm-hmm. You try to put that on focus. It's a philosophy. Philosophy has been around a long time. It was even in the Apostles' age when Paul had to speak to the, especially, well, I say it in the Colossians, so let no man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit. Let's go together. Philosophy and vain deceit. He says, after the rudiment of men and not after Christ. So the theme when we preach Christ, the Bible shows us that Christ is all sufficient. Now I need some extra trying to understand the plan of salvation. The plan of salvation is in Christ. Even the Jews did not fully understand what it means to live by faith. Paul, he writes in, it's written in Romans 10, Paul said, my desire to God for Israel, that's his own brethren, is that they might be saved. He says, I bear them record that they have a zeal of God, but not according to knowledge. Listen to what he said. They're going about to establish their own righteousness, have not submitted to the righteousness of God. But he goes on to say, what is the righteousness of God? He says, Christ is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone that believes.
Amen.
That's Romans 10, read it.
Yes, just read it.
So what he was saying there, the own religion that comes from a word use in the scripture, in the original language of the scripture, which is Greek. And I put it on the board because you would recognize it. The word is, what does that look like?
Idiot.
Idiot, doesn't it?
Idiot.
That's where you get the word idiot from. Idios. Idios means that something is huge and one. I hold on to it myself, this is the way I see it, and I ain't gonna let it go. Well, the Jews are like that. They had their tradition and their laws written by their scribes and the fathers of that day. They're not gonna let it go. I don't care what.
Yeah.
Paul comes preaching. Paul was of that persuasion, right?
Mm-hmm.
He comes preaching Christ, a revelation. No, we're not going to accept that. I'm going to keep with my law, my religion. But he says they're ignorant of the righteousness of God, in that they would not accept Christ as God's salvation. Amen?
Yes.
I thought I put it on there.
They called them simple people too, right?
Pardon me?
They called them simple people.
Who's that?
Those that wouldn't accept Christ, they wanted to stick to their law. They were they felt they were simple-minded people.
They call them ignorant.
Yeah.
You're
same
ignorant.
Thing.
Gotcha. You know, ignorant is it's a word for ignorant comes out of agnoia. That's the word to translate it. Simply what it means, this is a word for knowledge, it means without knowledge.
Yeah.
You have to keep a modifier. It means ignorance of God's righteousness, ignorant to God's plan. Be ignorant to his revelation that he has given. We don't want to accept it, so we're ignorant to it. We want to go, humankind want to go the way they want to go. And that is in the Bible, the word, the folk want to go the way they want to go, not according to God's will.
Right.
It is called pride. It's called pride. And we hear it in Habakkuk 2, don't you want us to listen to it? We're living in a philosophical age. It's being more philosophical than ever before. New thoughts coming out. Well, not new thoughts, old thoughts. Old thoughts are trying to be improved upon. Coming out almost momentarily. You see it coming. Turn on your TV, you see those thoughts. That's why the world is in turmoil. It has to do with ideology. Why is, for example, current? Look at France. Terrorism, rich France, right? You know what that's about? It's about how men think. Does the Muslim world think that the Muslim world has thoughts? The Western world has thoughts. The Western world is materialistic. Almost anything goes, morally. The Muslim world says no. Your world, the Western world, is materialistic. We like things and more things.
We're greedy.
And even our morality is down.
Mm-hmm.
Look at the Western world morality, anything goes. Folk who go around half naked, right? Not in the Muslim world.
No.
In the Muslim world, folk are covered, especially the ladies. They veil sometimes, right? Well, the reason for that is that it goes back. Keep from males lusting after females. The female has to be covered. That's the reason for that. Look at the Western world. Do as you please. Expose it all. So they said the Western world is trying to convert the world of the Muslim world. So we don't like it, we'll kill you. Talk about our leader and we'll kill you. And that's what happened, right? In these satirical comics, talked about the leader, right? Assassin came and boom.
Killed us several people, right?
That's thinking. Ignorant of God's righteousness. They establish a new one. Even the Western world is trying to establish their own righteousness. Middle East, their own righteousness. They've got all these ideologies clashing. That's where they put the problem for the most part in our world. It's called sin, because it's called sin because it's outside of God's righteousness. All right, and Habakkuk. Now keep in mind, we're going to this thing today, growing in grace through living by faith. That's the subject of the lesson. I'm going to look at Habakkuk chapter 2. The first five verses of chapter 2, what we're going to look at to see how this idea of faith is developed. Okay? Verse 1, we're going to read all tonight. Verse 1, I will stand upon my watch and set me upon the tower and will watch to see what he will say unto me and what I shall answer when I am reproved.
And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon tables, that he may run that readeth it.
For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come, it will not tarry.
Behold, his soul which is lifted up is not upright in him, but the just shall live by his faith.
All right, verse 5, let's read together.
Yea also, because he transgresseth by wine, he is a proud man, neither keepeth that home, who enlargeth his desire as hell,
and is as death, and cannot
be satisfied. But gathereth unto him all nations, and leapeth unto him all people.
Leapeth unto him all people. Now you notice here in Habakkuk, he said there's a vision is yet for an appointed time. Now here's a great principle. Here's a great principle. The Bible says in verse 4, behold, the soul which is lifted up is not upright in him. But the just or the righteous shall live by faith. This is a principle that has been set in Scripture. For the most part, humankind, this goes back, and humankind left God, out of creator, out of reckoning, they became proud and pride. Look at Genesis. God looked down upon man after man had fallen. Looked down upon man, he said, what did he say? There's none good.
No, not one. That's right.
Genesis, it says, God looked. It says, the imagination. Imagination is the image that one places in his or her mind. Before we do anything, we image it in the mind. Right?
Right.
Think about a chair there. I'm looking at a chair there that was imaged in someone's mind before it was manufactured. Mm-hmm. Interesting, engineer. Mm-hmm. That camera there was imaged in someone's mind before it was manufactured. But have you thought about that? You and I was imaged in the mind of our Creator before we were created. Matter of fact, the Bible says we are created. We are created in the image
of God. God.
You understand? Mm-hmm. In the image of God. Imaged. Imagination. So a man in his imagination, he went away from try to go away from his creator. Try to do everything on his own. That's pride. This is what the Bible talks about right now, to go to the New Testament and show that this principle we find in Habakkuk is also found in the New Testament. Go with me to Romans chapter 1. Romans chapter 1. Listen to the principle that you find in Habakkuk. Right? Listen, this is the apostle to the Gentiles, apostle Paul. He talks about God's righteousness. Mm-hmm. Think about God's righteousness as opposed to man's righteousness. The man has a righteousness of his own. Mm-hmm. God has a righteousness, and man has a righteousness, but of his own. Idios. So we have to understand, and in the scriptures we want to understand the righteousness of God. We got enough, human beings got enough righteousness of their own. That is not what's helping us. It's got the world in turmoil. It's upsetting all over the world. It's a righteousness of their own. And we tell you, I'm right. And any other, I'm right. Y'all are not right. That's what the Muslims said. The West, y'all are not right. We say, you, Eastern, y'all not right either. So you got to turn, boom. But in the midst of all that, what human beings, we talk about, I use it like it's the Middle East and the West should understand and try to come to the righteousness of God. When human beings come to the righteousness of God, if ever they could get there, guess what? We will have what is known as peace. It will never happen outside of... See, peace can only be had in the righteousness of God.
Right.
The righteousness of God is a person, and that's Jesus Christ. Peace can only be had when one gets into a right relationship with God through faith in Christ Jesus. That's why it's so important to preach the gospel. The gospel, when we preach the good news says righteousness is in Christ. It's God's righteousness. Listen to Apostle Paul. He was a Jew. He discovered it by revelation. All right, listen to what he says at verse 8 of Romans 1. He says, first, I thank my God through Jesus Christ. You notice what he said? I thank my God through Jesus Christ for you all. That your faith is spoken of throughout the whole world. All right, look at verse 9. For God is my witness, whom I serve with my spirit in the gospel of his Son, that without ceasing I make mention of you always in my prayers. Look at verse 10. Making requests, if by any means now, at length, I might have a prosperous journey by the will of God. Notice he always in by the will of God. You think about grace. God is gracious. By the will of God, you see that? To come unto you. For I long to see you, that I may impart unto you some spiritual gift, to the end you may be established. That is, that I may be comforted together with you by the mutual faith, both of you and me. Isn't it wonderful? I just want to comment here. The reason we're here today is we're sharing a mutual faith. Mm-hmm. Aren't we? Mutual faith together. You believe the same thing I believe, right?
Right.
And that's Jesus Christ, right?
Mm-hmm.
And we're sharing our mutual faith. We're coming to the scriptures. And we're looking into the scriptures to understand what? More of the righteousness of God, which is Jesus Christ. All right? Now, look again. It's mutual. I like that word, mutual. We come in together, our faith. All right, verse 13. Now, I would not have you ignorant. Okay, that word is it. Brethren, oft times I purposed to come unto you, but was led hitherto, that I might have some fruit among you also, even as among other Gentiles. Mm-hmm. See there in parentheses, that little word, hitherto. wonder what that, what does that mean? He says, I was, well, he said, I purpose to come unto you, but was let hitherto. That means up until now, right? And he's right. I was hindered, that's what it means. Let hitherto. I was hindered up until now. That reminded me, I remember when I graduated from high school, it's been, you believe I graduated from high school 60 years this year? 1955. I graduated from high school, right? It'd be 60 years out of high school. I had my graduation, they had what they call a baccalaureate sermon. And the preacher's sermon was, I remember this title, Hitherto the Lord Has Helped Us. And I didn't understand what he meant then, but I remember the sermon. So as I was going to study the Bible, I said, oh, this is what he was saying. He was saying to us from the first grade, from the first grade, even until now, at your graduation, the Lord has been with you.
Right.
I said, oh, that's where he got it from. As you regress, you come to understand that all that time, whole life, God has blessed you even until now. All right, what I had. All right, verse 14. Paul says, I am a debtor both to the Greek, that's the philosophers, and to the barbarians. That's barbarian is the one who is really ignorant. And they're ignorant because they can't even talk the language. They say, ba-ba. That's it. but they're vicious. And they are cruel barbarians. Both to the wise, he says, and to the unwise. So, listen to what he said now. Verse 15. He says, so as much as in me is, I am ready to preach the gospel to you that are at Rome also. Watch what he says in verse 16. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. Keep in mind, of Christ. He said this gospel source, see, of Christ is in the genitive case, which means the source is from Christ. Mm-hmm. Paul is saying, I didn't manufacture this. I didn't sit down and think about this. He says, I received this by revelation. God revealed it unto me. So he says, it's of Christ, the gospel of Christ. All right, watch what he says now about the gospel of Christ. For it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believe it. To the Jew first, and also to the Greek. And here comes the great principle that we found in Habakkuk 2. All right, verse 17, let's read it together. For therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith. And that's a great principle. Great principle. It's living, now, if we understand it as we work with it, it's not just living by faith, point blank. It's always living by faith in Christ Jesus. We have that's to say right. That, otherwise it
could be some faith
flip out there somewhere. What do you mean? Always faith in Christ Jesus. Right. In Christ Jesus, that's the faith. But why is it in Christ Jesus salvation? Because God the Father placed salvation in Christ.
Christ Jesus. Right. That's right.
That's the location. Mm-hmm. Permanently.
The end.
Salvation is permanently located in Christ. What does that mean? You can't find any salvation outside of Christ.
That's right.
Because God place salvation in Christ. So when we talk about faith, it's always faith in Jesus Christ. That principle of living by faith comes into the New Testament. We as believers have to understand, we must understand it if we're going to proclaim the gospel. If you and I don't understand it, we can't claim the gospel as revealed in Scripture. We'd be saying something, and usually when we say something, we're saying it out of our pride. here's where we go. Well, I feel, right. And I think, right. That's how you're talking pride. I feel and I think, Lord have mercy. I'm up here talking about, I feel and I think, and y'all said, I get you, Brother Melvin. He said, Brother Matthew, I don't feel and I don't think, I feel and I think. Everybody, I feel and I think. That's pride.
Yeah.
I feel. Everybody got some emotion, right? I feel and I think. Lord have mercy. But no wonder the world messed up. I feel and I think. Lord have mercy. But if you go back to the Bible, the just shall live by faith. So then, faith comes, I feel and I think. No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't. So then, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. I got a little loud there.
Yes.
The emphasis is that our faith comes from the word of God.
That's right.
And when we think about the word of God, we think about the revelation. It's a revelation. God's will has been revealed to you and me, and it's revealed in language. One thing about it, too, so we won't get so proud in what's been real in Revelation. We don't have, you and I don't know the original language Revelation came in. We don't speak the language. We are Westerners. And we speak broken English in the first place. Broken. It's all messed up. We all messed up, you know. And I didn't realize how messed up we are. You don't realize, schoolmate, they go to school or college and they come out with our chest. Like, I think we got
that's
something.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They really make it real proud. When I think about it, I say, they try to make me proud. Then turn around and say, I'm your mother. That's what alma mater means.
Can you explain that? You know,
I messed up with y'all. Which one? Me explain?
Oh, I messed up with y'all.
Yeah, can you explain that? Because you know what? I was in London for 15 days, and I did learn what you just said. We are messed up. But in London, it's different. They think we are messed up.
Oh yeah. Mm-hmm. So you get
think
it.
They think we are messed up.
Mm-hmm. And we think they're messed up, right?
We think they're messed up.
See, I told you, it's a philosophy.
I want to know why. I want to know why.
I don't know why. I tell you, it comes from being proud.
That's right.
That's the key. Proud of myself. I am. Well, we say, I'm it.
It's all about me.
Nobody like me. I'm it. I'm just it. Right.
Brother Matthew, we've been talking about faith a lot at home the last few weeks, and from the way it seems to us is that like there's a scripture, without faith it's impossible to please God.
Mm-hmm.
So then we look, well, how do you know where you are in your faith?
Mm-hmm.
So then, you know, there's some other scriptures that talk about fear and worry and doubt. So it's like, so when you have fear, worry, and doubt, you know, that should be signals to you that your faith is not strong.
Right.
I was just thinking about when Christ was sleeping in the boat with the apostles,
mm-hmm.
and the storm came up, and they were afraid.
Yes.
And, you know, their fear. And so when Jesus woke up, he says, O ye of little faith,
that's right.
Because they were showing fear.
Yes.
So we believe that God is protecting us and with us all the time. What are we scared of? What should we be afraid of?
Right.
That's right. The reason we get afraid, you know why we get afraid? We get back into ourselves.
That's right. That's thank you.
that's why we're here.
Back into ourselves.
Yes, into ourselves. We are born, well, we are born as soon as we become aware we in ourselves.
Yes.
Yeah, we don't realize it. You know, we have to be taught. Somebody teach us where we are. And only God, through the scripture, can teach us where we are. Getting back to sister, dear. The way we really understand the gospel, really understand the gospel, then It should be canceled.
That's right.
Getting back to faith. Faith is, I put it like this, faith is, let me put it like this. Faith is simple. It's hard to grasp. Let me put it this way. As a matter of fact, the Bible says, the just shall live by faith. But here's what you need to understand. Faith is, in the language, is only a noun. It's naming an idea. How are you going to, do you live on a noun? No. Noun is a, keep in mind, noun is an idea. It does say the just shall live by faith. But something must happen for us to understand how it's done. How do we live by faith?
We're learning the word of God.
This is Brenda, got it. We can only live by faith when we rely upon the word of God. All right, when we rely upon the word of God, whatever rely means. You want to talk about it, Sister Brenda?
Well, you read it, you understand it, and you live it.
All right. Something has to happen to the noun.
That's right. That's right. When you rely. I think when you rely on something, that means you submit to that.
All right, you submit to it.
Yeah.
Well, what are we going to do with the noun?
Becomes an action word.
Which noun? Pride?
No, with the noun faith.
Oh, with the noun faith?
What are we going to do with
it? Becomes a verb.
You have to find a verb.
Yeah, but put it in action.
That's right.
You have to find a verb, but otherwise you can't live. No. You have to live by faith. It's an idea.
That's right.
But what is a verb in the, in the English language? There it is.
You're doing something. You believe.
That's the way you spell belief. Listen to the Bible and show you how the English Bible try to bring it down. I'm thinking of a scripture in Hebrews 11 and verse 6. Hebrews 11 and verse 6. Let's see it. Let me see it. Watch this. I think this is a good text to bring it out. Hebrews 11 and verse 6. The apostle says,
but without faith.
But without faith.
It is impossible.
Let's move slowly. But without faith. Faith, you said, is a noun, right?
Mm-hmm.
But without faith,
it is impossible
to please God.
That's right.
All right, that's good. Well, all right. Yeah. Watch this now. Watch the text. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. Mm-hmm. But he that comes to God must believe.
That's right. Yes.
Mm-hmm. That he is.
Yeah.
See the change? You see the change?
Mm-hmm.
What did you say?
It went from a noun to a verb and then back,
right.
To a, back to a noun.
You see?
Mm-hmm.
You have to understand it when you read the text,
right.
Otherwise, see? Faith is an idea. But the idea must become flesh. So you got the idea of one another, it got to become flesh. How did the idea of faith become flesh? It became flesh in Christ Jesus. Over and over again in the Bible, when the gospel is preached, it's belief in Christ Jesus. I believe Christ Jesus. It's always Christ Jesus.
Yes.
Christ Jesus. Why is so much Christ Jesus? Because in our minds, the word has become flesh. When we see Christ, we behold with our eyes faith. Not only do we behold with our eyes faith, but we behold with our eyes grace.
Mm-hmm.
You see, the word grace in the abstraction is out there somewhere. It's an idea. Right? The word is idea floating around there, words. Ideas are floating. And the word, come on, came to be flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory.
Yes.
As of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Yes, sir.
Now, I can understand grace. All I have to do is gaze at Jesus. As a matter of fact, the Bible tells us that in Hebrews, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith.
That's right.
Well, that's what Paul says.
Yeah.
I mean, I didn't see that. He hear me cry out loud because I see it now. Finally, I see it. I didn't always see it. It was all in abstraction. What is that preacher talking about? I hear words, but I don't understand. But it sounds good. People be dancing and shouting. It sounds good. Yeah. I was sitting there. What are you talking about? What are those people doing? But oh, when the revelation becomes flesh, you see it. Mm-hmm. It brings about a change in one's life.
Yes.
The just shall live by faith. Now, to live by faith, I'll tell you what faith does. When we're living by faith, we want to grow in the grace of God. In order to grow in the grace of God, growing in grace, in order to grow in the grace of God, it all begins, we must consider faith. Faith must be understood. Yes, faith must be understood. It must be action. So we must believe the revelation that God has given you. Okay? Look what happens when we believe.
Where are you now, Brother Matthews? You're back in Rome?
I'm just talking.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Romans 5, verse 2. See, this is a brief. Where are you, Brother Matthews?
That's
you know,
right.
We're in Scripture, right?
I'm just right.
Thinking about Scripture.
I want to see it with my eyes.
There you are. There you are. I want to see it. She said, I want to see it with my eyes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right. Now we're going to let you see what I'm talking about in my mind. All right. Look at Romans 5 and verse 1. Keep in mind that faith does it. We have a word in our language, access.
Mm-hmm.
Access. Mm-hmm. A-C-C-E-S is what it is. Mm-hmm. What does that mean to your mind? Access.
Connection. I can get to you. I can get to it.
Access.
That's right.
Access. I want to get to it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. Got the idea? Okay. Watch this. Look at Romans 5, verse 1. Let's read together. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Now notice the term, I'm going to keep it before you, through our Lord Jesus Christ, mm-hmm. by our Lord Jesus Christ, in Christ. You see, all those terms, those terms are important.
Mm-hmm.
By Christ, in Christ, through Christ. You know why it's given? Because the grace of God is manifested in Christ. He's full of grace. So if I want to have grace at all, I got to be where? Located in Christ.
Amen.
As a matter of fact, that's a spiritual blessing.
Yes, it is.
In Christ.
We get some blessings from
the Bible says all spiritual blessings are where? In Christ. All right? Did you understand Romans 5 and verse number 1? Look at verse number 2. Right? Let's read the verse number 2. By whom we also have access by faith into this grace, wherein we stand and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. Well, that's a powerful. It's a powerful stuff in our own language. First thing I see in verse 1.
Peace.
That I cannot justify myself. See that at verse 1?
Mm-hmm.
How do I know I know from verse 1? Well, it's something about the grammar. Grammar is important.
Yes.
Yes, it is, Brother Brad said, yes, it is. You have in the language, just share with you. We have in the language, verbs have voice. Two voices that we, for me would, is active voice and passive voice. The active voice means that the subject is acting. For example, we had in our English books, you remember that? The boy or the girl hit the ball. Active voice means the subject is acting. And then we turn it around, say the boy or the girl was hit by the ball. Oh! Got it? Why do you get it?
Victor.
What's the difference?
One is passive and one is active.
Well, it's true, but explain it. When I give the second one, I say, ouch!
Yeah, you did it.
What happened?
Something happened to you.
Something happened to
one,
you. Yeah.
One you're doing and one is something's being done
to you.
Yeah, you got it. Oh, here's a fastball coming 90 miles an hour. And the pitcher's after me. You want to hit me.
Let's turn that around.
I was acting a pun. You get it?
Yes, sir.
All right. Here it is. Being justified, that's passive voice. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. Is it? In other words, if you're going to plead that you have been justified, you better add, and add it fast.
Through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Through our Lord Jesus Christ.
That's right.
If you don't add it fast, somebody says, oh, hear Brother Matthew say he is righteous. I better hurry with that. Through Jesus Christ. All comes as a spiritual blessing in Christ Jesus. And we access those spiritual blessings through faith. And that faith must be action. I believe what God has done for me in Christ Jesus. Wow. Any questions? I'm glad we all got it. Sister. I like what you said. We get this, we're not messed up anymore. No, we're not messed up anymore once we grasp the gospel. Because all pride is gone. You never testify, look at me. It's always look to Jesus.
That's right.
Why do we gaze upon Jesus? Because he is the author of our faith. And he is the finisher. That means he completes it.
He's over.
Our faith.
Yeah.
How did he live? Jesus lived in the Spirit.
Yeah.
You know why he did that? So that we might know how to live. He didn't live in higher than we did in the flesh. In the flesh, he lived like any other human being, trusting in what? Trusting in whom? Uh-huh. Trusting in his Father. Mm-hmm. How did I know he trusted in his Father? Through prayer? Mm-hmm. Jesus prayed.
He sure did.
He's about to enter. Whatever he's doing, he prayed. Father.
Even to the end.
Father, your will be done. Mm-hmm. Not as I will, your will be done. You remember when he was facing the cross for you and me? And he was sweating as sweat was as drops of blood. And he prayed, his Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass. That was suffering.
Yeah.
Facing death. Let this cup pass from me. And he says, nevertheless, not as I will, but thy will be done. And he got up and he said, let's be going.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, that's a powerful scripture.
He denied himself.
Oh, yes. He said, let us be going.
Mm-hmm.
He's ready. Well, you and I have to do the same thing. What keeps us going in this wicked world? Faith in Christ Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Watching what he has done and living. He says, follow me. How are we going to follow him? Well, when fear seems to be there, fear seems to be there, and it is sometimes, right? Father, I don't understand what is going on now, Lord, your will be done. Help! That's what we had. Help! Don't you know that scripture?
That's right. Help
me. I come before you and I'm calling to pray and I'm saying, the Lord God of heaven, we praise your name. Help! Amen.
Mm-hmm. Short.
You know what folk would probably say, some folk would probably say?
That's too short.
Hey, Matthew, he hasn't prayed. We're so used to what? Tradition. That'd be some long drawings.
Three words, right, Brother Matthew?
Yep.
One God word. Help me.
Lord help me. All right, you go.
And then,
Lord,
Jesus Christ.
Help me. Three words, right? Okay. Mm-hmm. Amen.
So you don't have to have a lot of words.
Us.
No.
Don't you not have Bibles with us?
You don't need a
Hebrews
lot of words.
Hebrews 4. Saying then we have a great high priest. Got to shut up here. Seeing then we have a great high priest who has gone into the heavens, Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Tells us he was touched with our infirmities. He went through the same thing we have in all points, tempted like us we are, yet without sin. And then in that text it says, let us come boldly to the throne of grace to obtain mercy and to find grace to help in time of need. Amen. So be it. Let's pray. Oh, and our God, we're so grateful for the revelation of your word, that you've made it simple, but sometimes we make it difficult. We must believe and take you at your word and do what you have commanded. We're so grateful that the word became flesh in your Son and dwelt among us, held his glory. As the only begotten of the Father, he was full of grace and truth. Help us, Lord, in our pilgrimage here on earth, to live by faith, access your grace. It's our prayer in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.